Good morning, students. Today's topic is automation and clinical chemistry. So you all know what is automation, what is the use of auto analyzers and clinical chemistry and all. So you've been seeing technicians working on these auto analyzers, right? So today we'll be seeing about those techniques. Okay, what is automation and what is an auto analyzer? What are the benefits of that? So all those will be seeing in today's class. So under these headings we'll be studying. So first the introduction, then instrumentation, types of analyzers and benefits of these automation technique and applications. So first coming to the introduction, so you have to understand the term automation. So this has been applied in clinical laboratory science to describe the maximum use of specimen processing equipments and reagent handling instruments to perform tests, okay, with minimum involvement of laboratory technologists or technicians. So automation means that, so you process the sample, you make use of equipments, you make use of specimen processing techniques, okay, with all those and minimum labor or minimum involvement of laboratory technologists. So that is called automation. And what do you mean by auto analyzer? It is an instrument that performs analysis of sample or specimen by means of automation. Okay, so auto analyzers, they enable processing of large number of specimens without comparable increase in the laboratory steps. You would have observed in laboratory so many samples come, but if they are doing under semi-automatic or outdated this thing, it would have been taken a very long time and people also are required in more numbers. Whereas by using automation and auto analyzers, n number of samples you can analyze with minimum involvement of laboratory staff. So mainly why was this auto analyzer used? Due to the increased workload in laboratories. See, for each and everything now, first they go for a lab to get the blood test done. So in that many tests come. So this automation auto analyzers, it is not only particularly about biochemistry. Even in pathology also it is there. Microbiology also, and in blood bank few other auto analyzers they use. And so similarly it is applicable for all the departments. Okay, and this automation is a self-regulating process where the specimen is pipetted out accurately, mixed with particular volume of reagent, and the results are displayed on the screen, and that results can also be printed. So all these benefits we have in automation. Now coming to the classification of this auto analyzers, see, mainly auto analyzer is classified into continuous flow analyzer and discrete auto analyzer. Again, in continuous it is divided into single channel continuous flow analyzer and multiple channel continuous flow analyzer. In discrete we have fully automated and semi-automated analyzers. Again, in fully we have batch analyzers and random access analyzers. So what are these types, what are the advantages, disadvantages, each one by one we'll be looking at. Okay, so first coming to continuous flow analyzer. So the name itself is telling, there is a continuous flow of what? Of samples and reagents. Okay, they are passed sequentially in the same analytical pathway and they are separated by air bubbles and they are mixed in one common tube. This continuous flow analyzer will have probe to take out the sample, to take out reagent, sampler to hold the sample, proportioning pump to analyze the pathway of the samples passing through it, samples and reagent, dialyzer to obtain a protein-free filtrate, then heating bath, water bath is there, if the mixture has to be incubated at some temperature, that is made use of, and colorimetry to take the readings, printer to print out the values or results what you have got. And what are the advantages of this? A large number of sample can be analyzed for a particular test. Very accurately and precisely it can be done. And one disadvantage is only one type of determination is done at a time. Okay, you can't, for a particular sample, example, you can analyze only glucose or only urea. You can't analyze both glucose and urea at a time. One investigation at a time. So that is a main disadvantage here. And one more is it occupied a large space. All these continuous flow analyzers and all, now it is outdated. It is not being used. Before it was, they were using. Same like your computers. Now we have laptops, tabs and all. Before, how the computer size was? It was very bigger, slow. Okay, it used to occupy more place also and limited applications. As in when the versions got updated, the computer size also reduced and the usage of that computers, more number of applications, portability, all these are there. So same like computer, here are the auto analyzers also. Okay, then coming to multiple channel flow analyzer. Here single channel flow analyzer, only one type of investigations. Here two models are there. These were the company models, Technicon SMA 660, Technicon SMA 1260. 660 means 6 tests can be done and 60 specimens can be analyzed per hour. So same 1260 model, 12 tests can be done, 60 specimens per hour. And one disadvantage here is the physician might not be interested in what all tests it is done. They might ask only 2 or 3 investigations, but the instrument is giving all 6 or 12 tests together. They might not be interested in all those things. Okay, so that is the disadvantage. Now coming to discrete on auto analyzer. Here, this is most sophisticated type. It coordinates multiple operations with functioning smoothly system. And basic features of this discrete analyzer is reagent and specimens are pipetted into a cuvette and mixed end product is recorded photometrically. This is all is getting done in our auto analyzer also. And all types of assays, endpoint, two-point assay, kinetics, everything can be done. More than 100 tests can be done, not samples, more than 100 tests. Then it is also economical because the reagents quantity used is in microliters. We are not using more quantity of reagents. And patient-wise report we can see. Here also in our lab system you would have observed each patient-wise report, if we click, it will display the results. And quality control we can run. Okay, both internal quality, external quality we can be done. Every day QC is being done, isn't it? And results are stored. Suppose backdated results, if we want, if we can just put the ID number or name, whatever is available, and it will display the results. And apart from routine chemistry, apart from glucose, cholesterol, liver function, kidney function, special chemistry can also be done, like your hormone assays. Okay, and fertility profiles. So all those special chemistry investigations also can be done. And one important feature is it is user friendly. Once you get to know how it has to be done, you can easily move on with the auto analyzer. Okay, all these are basic features of auto analyzer. Now coming to semi auto analyzer. Why it is called semi? Because initial stages of sample analysis is done in a done by a laboratory technician. This also you would have seen, you would have worked with this semi-auto analyzer, isn't it? So what all the technicians has to do? Pipetting the reagent, pipetting samples, mixing of those, incubating, again taking it back, taking the reading. So all these things is done by a technician. Okay, part or like giving out taking out the reading and giving displaying the values is done by auto analyzer. Okay, and printing also, and graphs also is displayed, and it gets plotted in the auto analyzer, semi auto analyzer. And these are the features of semi auto analyzer. This is also economical. Here also the reagent volume we use is very less. This is also user friendly, and SOPs can be stored here, standard operating procedures. I hope you all know about standard operating procedures. So whenever you have time, please go through. Since you are in final year, this is useful. So for each instrument, there is an SOP. And for each procedure, for each analyte, there is a SOP. So go through that. And absorbance versus wavelength graph also gets plotted. And it prints and displays the parameters on the screen. And statistical analysis also can be done. Standard deviation, Levy-Jennings chart, those also are done in a can be done in a semi-auto analyzer. Apart from routine chemistry, here immunoassay, coagulation profile, drug assays also can be done in a semi-auto analyzer. This depends on the semi-auto analyzer company and the model. Basic model will have limited applications. So in semi only, good models and versions are there, updated ones that can be made use for drug assays also, and this can work without power also with the help of battery backup system. And semi analyzer, three types are there. This is based on the complexity level of the labs. Smaller labs, you can have a simple semi auto analyzer, little bigger. So that's what I told, depending on the complexity of the lab, level of the lab, semi-auto analysis can be made use of. First type of semi-analyzer is, it will have a built-in dry block at 37 degree centigrade. It will have 12 cuvette positions, it will have 1 cuvette reading and all manual operations. So example is Minilab, 0.180 plus, all these are names of the instrument or the company model names. Second type is semi with built-in fixed metal thermocouvette. This is operated by auto aspiration and washed by a peristaltic pump, like Metro Lab 1600 plus, 1600 plus, Biotron BTR 810. All these are the models. Then analyzers with triple cuvette system. That means flow cell it will have, manual square it will have, manual round tube for coagulation. So separate triple cuvette system it will have. So models under this type of analyzer is Erbach M5 plus, Erbach M-Fro. Okay, so here I want you all to make a note. So when you all come back, so go to the lab and see what semi-auto analyzer is there, what is the model, and in what category it falls. Okay, what all it does. Next, coming to fully auto analyzer. So fully auto, name itself is telling, it is fully automatic. You need not do anything, just you have to keep the sample, that's all. Everything is done by itself, like dispensing of reagent using reagent probe. For sample, it will have sample probe. Separate probes are there for everything. And mixing is done separately. Incubation is done in one place. Okay, it is a very sophisticated type. Then it performs all the work that a semi-auto analyzer does. Plus, it will have sampler to accommodate samples. It is not only the one sample you are doing at a time. Many samples you can keep it at a time. So that is a sampler, and along with the samples you can keep standard also, calibrator also, QC materials also. All this can be accommodated in a sampler. This facility is not there in semi-auto or any other type of analyzer. Then there is a programmable sample probe. So sample volume can be decided. It can be programmed by 3 microliter to 30 microliter. So in this range it can be done. And it has sensors also. Sample and reagent probe. Level sensors. So below this level it can't do the test. So level sensors are there. Then reagent carousel is there. What is that? Various reagents can be kept. arranged in that reagent carousel. And some investigations require one reagent, only R1 will be there. Some will require R1, R2. So all these reagents can be arranged in a reagent carousel. Then reusable reaction cells will be there. Then wash cycles are there, which are programmable. Then there is cuvette rinsing station. This cleans the cuvette with detergent and deionized water. So why this is important? To provide a precise and reliable result, we make use of this cuvette rinsing. Then coming to batch analyzer, this has become outdated. So most of the lab are not using this type of batch analyzer. So here also one test at a time is done. Samples will be separated, and batch wise you can do. Suppose all the samples you can collect, and if glucose has to be analyzed, only glucose for all the samples can be done. So similarly for other investigations also, and only one type of reagent can be placed. So analyzers can be programmed with number of samples on the sampler. So one disadvantage of this is it is not patient oriented. It has no random access analysis. What is random access analysis? So random access analysis means completing all the tests of one sample before proceeding to the next. So that facility is lacking in batch analyzer. So random access analyzers, so it has everything that a batch analyzer does, except according to the sample size it will have this random access mode also. There is sample orientation mode also. Then completing greatest number of samples in shortest time, this is the one main advantage or feature of this random access analyzer. And sequential mode is one type of analyzer, one type of test at a time. Then there is cuvette disk with temperature control. So if some investigations or some analyte determination requires incubation at some particular temperature, that is done by a temperature control knob that is there in the cuvette disk. Then there is reagent table with single or double reagent, as I told you, and level sensors here also it is present. Sample rack system is there. Here along with the samples, QC and calibrator also can be placed. Then barcode identification feature is there, and continuous loading of samples. So some instruments, once you keep and close the analyzer, it can't be open till the test is finished. But nowadays the machine models or auto analyzers which is coming, this will have this facility, that is continuous loading of samples. Then there is auto dilution facility also. If there is any variation with the test results, if it is very low or it is very high, the instrument itself will go for auto dilution. Whereas while using semi, the technician has to do this dilution. But here in fully automated, that is done automatically. Then there is a QC charts plotting daily and monthly wise. Levy Jennings chart is plotted. That is also done by instrument also, instrument only. And availability of ISC. So what is ISC? It is ion selective electrode for analyzing or for estimation of electrolytes like sodium chloride, calcium or potassium. So this is made use. So separate electrolyte analyzer is not required, necessary. So since ISC is there, that can be done here itself. And now finally coming to the benefits of automation. So till now we saw what is automation and different types of analyzer, what are the features of it, and advantage, disadvantages we saw. Now overall benefit of automation we will see. Large number of samples can be tested in short time. That is one benefit. And all endpoint or kinetics, any type of reaction can be done. And chemiluminescence, turbidimetry, etc. All these principles are made use of it. Then except routine chemistry, hormones, drug assay, tumor marker estimation, then various antibodies and protein detection also can be done using autoanalyzer. Then the results obtained are very accurate, precise, sensitive and specific. Then although there are various types of autoanalyzer, it is quite expensive because since it has all these advantages and benefits, it is quite expensive. But the reagents and specimens which we are using is very low. Minimum quantity we can use that is in microliters. Okay. Then automation allows larger workload handling with less number of staffs. Then internal quality control and external quality control can be done. And in case of fully automated analyzer, the staff doesn't come in direct contact with the specimens, okay, biohazardous materials. So hence working in this analyzer is safe. Okay. So this completes this automation and auto analyzer. And one assignment I want you all to write is the application of this auto analyzer. Okay, where all it is applied, what all we can estimate, I want you all to make a note. So when you all come back, you can submit it. So go through textbooks, okay, and internet source, make a note of all those things. Okay, I hope you all understood about automation, types of analyzers and benefits of it. Okay, thank you.